हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम एटी तलवारे। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द लेक्चर नंबर 4, सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ गैस टरबाइन पावर प्लांट। इन दिस लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द वर्क रेशियो, ऑप्टिमम प्रेशर रेशियो फॉर मैक्सिमम नेट वर्क एंड इंटरमीडिएट टेम्परेचर। लेट अस विल स्टार्ट। द work ratio is defined as the ratio of network output to the work done by the turbine. So therefore work ratio is equal to the network is expressed in terms of wt minus wc, where wt is work obtained from the turbine and wc is work supplied to the compressor. This network, that is wt minus wc upon wt. So this is the TS diagram for the gas turbine cycle. The work ratio as we have defined and written in terms of WT and WC. Now we can keep the WT is equal to mCp T3 minus T4. This temperature T3 minus T4. Here is the turbine part. This is the reversible adiabatic expansion in the turbine, minus this is the reversible adiabatic compression process in the compressor, that is equal to mCp T2 minus T1. So by keeping these values of WT, WC and WT, we'll get this expression. By cancelling the common terms, we'll get this expression. And by taking the common T1 and T3 and replacing the T2 by T1 and T4 by T3 in terms of pressure ratio RP, so we'll get this expression. And finally, cancelling the common terms, we'll get this expression. So that is 1 minus T1 upon T3 RP raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So this is the expression of work ratio in terms of minimum temperature, maximum temperature and pressure ratio, and the gamma is ratio of specific heat. Now the second part of this lecture is the derivation of optimum pressure ratio for maximum network for given maximum and minimum temperature. The minimum temperature in the gas turbine is limited by or decided by the atmospheric conditions, that is let us say 300 Kelvin. The maximum temperature of the gas turbine cycle is decided by the material which is used, which can sustain the maximum temperature. So this maximum temperature cannot exceed beyond a certain limit, let us say 1300 Kelvin, which will be decided by the material used for the gas turbine blade or the other parts. So let us say this is maximum temperature is 1300 Kelvin. Now the area represented here, so that is dotted line, so that area represents the work done during the cycle. More the area, so more will be the maximum work. So based on that, we can say that if pressure ratio, let us say pressure ratio is 5, so we'll get this type of this much is the area. And if we if you increase the pressure ratio to, let us say RP is equal to 20, you'll get this much is the area. And there is a pressure ratio in between this 5 and 20, let us say 13, for which we'll get this area is the maximum, which represents the W net max. And for a particular pressure ratio, that is RP, in terms of temperature, maximum temperature and minimum temperature, so RP is equal to for maximum network, the pressure ratio should be equal to T max upon T minimum raised to gamma upon 2 gamma minus 2. So this expression will derive in the further slides. Okay. So now the derivation for the optimum pressure ratio for maximum network. Here WC is the work required for compressor is written in terms of specific heat and temperature. At T2 and T1, that is Cp T2 minus T1, and WT is written in terms of Cp T3 and T4, this Cp and T4. As per the definition, W net is equal to WT minus WC, By keeping this WT and WC here, we'll get this expression. WNet is equal to, now the T3 is taken common here and T1 is taken common from the second expression. We'll get this expression. Now, by replacing this temperature ratio in terms of pressure ratio, we will get this expression. Now, for the given temperature limit of T1 is equal to T minimum and T3 is equal to T max, the net work will be maximum when the differentiation of W net expression with respect to pressure ratio RP is equal to 0. Let us replace gamma minus 1 upon gamma is equal to x to simplify this expression, and by keeping this gamma minus 1 upon gamma by x, we will get this expression. By taking the RP in the numerator, we will get this expression. Now, the differentiating this expression, the derivation, the dW net upon dRP is equal to 0. So, by differentiating this Tp and T3 is constant in brackets. So, this is 0. Differentiation of constant is 0 minus this differentiation of rp raised to minus x is minus x into rp raised to minus x minus 1 minus this Tp and T1 is constant, then rp raised to x differentiation is x into rp raised to x minus 1 minus this 0. Okay, so up to this and W net upon D differentiation of W net with respect to pressure ratio is equal to 0. That expression, that the further expression will be this, and cancelling the common terms, that is Cp, will get this expression. Again cancel the x common here, will get this expression. Then again cancelling Rp raised to minus 1, will get this expression. Now only finally, we'll get T3 Rp raised to minus x is equal to T1 Rp raised to x. Therefore, T3 upon T1 is equal to Rp raised to x upon Rp raised to minus x. By simplifying this, we'll get this expression, Rp is equal to T3 upon T1 raised to 1 upon 2 into x. On substituting the value of x, so we'll get pressure ratio is equal to T3 upon T1 raised to gamma upon 2 in bracket gamma minus 1, where T3 is nothing but T max and T1 is nothing but T minimum. So, this is the expression for pressure ratio for which we will get the maximum net work. Now, we will see the expression for the intermediate temperature T2, this intermediate temperature T2, so in terms of T1 and T3, where T1 is the minimum temperature, T3 is the maximum temperature. So, to determine T2 in terms of temperature T1 and T3, for maximum work, Rp is equal to T3 upon T1 raised to gamma upon 2 in bracket gamma minus 1. But Rp is equal to T2 upon T1 raised to gamma upon gamma minus 1. So, equating this by keeping this value here, so we will get this expression by cancelling the common term, and here replacing this. This T1 in terms of square root of T1 and cancelling the common terms, will get this expression, that is T2 intermediate temperature is equal to square root of the maximum temperature into minimum temperature. So this is the expression of the intermediate temperature for maximum net work in terms of temperature, minimum temperature and maximum temperature. Okay, we'll stop here. Thank you.